In this series of webcasts, we'll be continuing our discussion of pericyclic reactions. We'll take a look at the sigmatropic rearrangement, and we'll also look at the electrocyclic rearrangement. Both of these are unimolecular rearrangements, meaning that there's only a single molecule involved, and both of them involve changes in the sigma bond count. The sigma bonds are made as well as broken, and so for that reason, you might anticipate that either sigma or sigma star is going to be involved in our FMO analysis. Furthermore, because these are unimolecular processes, you might anticipate that both the HOMO and the LUMO will have to be contained within the molecule that's undergoing the rearrangement. We're going to see that we divide the molecule into distinct HOMO-LUMO domains. On the left-hand side, we have examples of electrocyclic reactions. The top case is what's known as a ring closure. It takes a linear pi system of alternating single and double bonds and makes a new ring out of it with an increase in the sigma bond count by plus one. The bottom case is the exact reverse of the top case. Here we have a loss of a sigma bond. There's a cyclic ring system that opens up to form a linear pi system. In the sigmatropic rearrangements, the net number of sigma bonds that are made and broken is zero. The reason for this is because there is one sigma bond formation and one sigma bond breaking. The way I like to view this sigma bond formation and breaking is as though there's a sigma bond migration. If you look at the example that's illustrated, you can see that this carbon-hydrogen bond breaks during the reaction, and it's as though it migrates to this position here, where the new sigma bond forms. The sigma bond moves five carbon atoms, and I'll give you the details later on, but that has to do with why we call it a 1,5 sigmatropic rearrangement. If you need more information or would like to see some great visualization of these reactions, go ahead and follow the link in your course notes. You'll get to the Darmstadt site, and there you can find additional reading material as well as some very nice animations of these processes. Here's a movie that illustrates the 1,5 sigmatropic rearrangement, and you can see that there's really not a lot of movement involved in passing this carbon-hydrogen bond from one side of the molecule to the other. In the upcoming webcast, we're going to begin by looking at the details of the electrocyclic ring opening reaction and ring closing reaction.